All right. So today we're going to do a quick inspection. They've been in this box for 4 days since removing it from the nuke. And we're going to look and see how the wax production is coming along. And noticed a small sampling of varroa mite. So I'm going to do a quick powdered sugar dusting as well today and follow up every weekend for the next 2 or 3 weeks to get a hold of those guys. So stand by. Get my sliding bottom board back in there so I can catch the powdered sugar and the varroa and check that in a day or two. Get ready here to light my smoker. And I'm gonna try not to even use any smoke today. I'll give him one tiny hint. Just a little bit to let him know, hey. This is their sugar water. They've been using it a little bit. Just wanted to get them off to a healthy start. And remove this. Place it off to the side. It's a real gentle puff. Expect to see much on these outside frames. Everything in order. Oh yeah. You can see here, this is a lot of really nice capped honey coming in there. I don't know if you can see this, but boy oh boy. A lot of pollen. Put one more on here just to give me a little extra room. The rest of them I can slide. Yeah, sweetheart. Just gonna do a quick peek, see what's going on. Got a lot of festooning going on here. Oh, they're busy here. nice. And they're just mildly irritated at me, but not much. This is what I wanted to see. This is one of the inner frames, and you can see, oh yeah, look at all the festooning going on here. And you can see that they're really preferring the foundationless frames. And they've been very, very busy. This was all empty 4 days ago. There's the queen. You can see that big, beautiful queen walking around. Big, long, beautiful girl. I hope you can see it. Not sure if you can or not. But that's her right there. Give her a little bit of room, but they're keeping an eye on her. And you can see this beautiful wax they're making. This is off one of the foundationless frames I put in. That's beautiful. That's exactly what I wanted to see. It's lined up nicely. The comb's lined up nice. So that was my primary mission today, to see how these foundationless frames are coming along. And to spot my queen, and that was an early easy spot. So these I'm just gonna take a quick look at. Oh, that's hell heavy. This is just, the population is much larger already than when I first put them in. You can see they're busy. Right here, they're busy taking care of brood and storing some honey and pollen. Beautiful. This is another foundationless frame. I basically checkerboarded them on, put them in. I checkerboarded the foundationless frame, every other foundation frame. And as with the other one, look at that. They're building beautiful fresh wax. And I expect I'm going to be able to show you something really interesting on this next frame. This next frame, I'm not a big fan of, because it is all plastic. And when I first got this nuke, I noticed they weren't building very much on it. And look at this. This is exactly as it was when I put it in. They pretty much refused to continue building on this. And this hasn't got much larger either. I think they're basically taking care of what brood was already in there. In my opinion, they prefer building foundationless, and they have pretty much abandoned the back side of this plastic frame in favor of building their own honeycomb. So that's awesome. I'm a big fan of foundationless beekeeping because I think it's much more natural for them. They haven't started on this one yet, but the other two they've gung-ho on. And I hope audio-wise you can hear me. If not, feel free to ask any questions or clarification. We're almost done. We've got a lot done here. Here is just tons of capped honey. I'm not going to worry about those crazy cells at the bottom because I'm going to basically rotate these out eventually as they go to the top box. So I'm not going to do any work there. And over here we got a foundationless they haven't touched yet either. So we're going to close them back up. We're going to get them all there. I'm going to give them a little dusting of powdered sugar to help them with their mites. A cursory peek, I don't really see any mites on their backs or anything going too crazy, so it's I think it's a pretty low mite population at this point. You can see they're getting a little bit there. Come on, give me a break, man. Nothing major. Just a little bit across the top, just to kind of have them buckle down. See, they don't like that, so you don't need to reach out to this person. I just don't want to smash them in between these frames, but I got to get them snug enough to get everything tucked in. But there's a, just go nice and slow. Tuck them in. They'll be happy here in a moment. wiggling in real slow. They got their B space in there. That one's heavy, boy. That is heavy. We'll be able to harvest that in a few months as we get rid of these foundation frames. Okay, let's get these centered up. A little bit. Just lucky little buggers. Get a nice dusting here. 1 cup per brood box. And we'll get it across the top here real nice. Those varroa mites. I also have oxalic acid treatments available, but I don't think I need to go that severe yet. It's pretty small hive right now. And they're getting a little irritated by this, nothing major. Kind of like, what the heck? Got my bottom board in there, so I'll leave that in and I'll do this. First checked, there was about a dozen in the bottom board, which isn't a lot. I want this in there. I don't want to hurt my girls. I wanted to drop in on them. So they're a little irritated by that, obviously. But they're going to get happy here pretty quick because I'm done messing with them. Best friend. That's it. That's it. Quick inspection. That took us all of about 13, 14 minutes. The hive looks healthy. The queen's there. They're building some beautiful wax. They got a little dusting to help them with those little mites, and I'm happy camper. Thanks, everybody, for watching.